Good morning, children. Welcome back to your third and final video for this week. And we are in the revision mode for standard 9, and we'll be discussing The Lost Child, another important chapter that we studied long ago, and we think a few points of it must be discussed. So, The Lost Child, the author is Mulk Raj Anand, and he has written a beautiful story. The story is important from the point of view is from the moral value that it tries to teach. Is the moral value is we don't know the importance of things once we have it, but we realize the importance of the simplest thing that we think is in our possession when we lose it. Now this is a story of a child who lost his parents who didn't value. He ran around living in his own world, living in his own dream that he created for himself. But once he lost his parents, he realized that they were the most valuable things that he ever needed, not the things that he thought were important for him. Now let's begin this chapter. As I told you, The Lost Child has been written by Mulk Raj Anand. The story begins with, it takes you back to a village background, right? We're talking about an age where there was no cell phones, no video gaming, nothing. The only time it was to be fun, it was for children to be having fun, was going to a fair that was organized seasonally. Spring, of course, it arrives after autumn and winter. So what happens during spring is people like to celebrate. The weather is nice and they like to go out, celebrate things. And in earlier days, the best way to celebrate anything was visiting a fair, because there were assorted things that were available over there and you can enjoy yourself, you can see different things. It's not like today's age where internet, you can see anything. In a mid of winter, you can watch summer happening in the southern hemisphere. So this child was running through the street. He was not bothering about staying with his father. He was attracted to the toy shop. You can see the picture of a toy shop. He was attracted to them. He wanted to buy those toys. And of course, the father couldn't afford buying all these things. Or maybe the father thought it was not necessary to buy the toy, because it would be a waste. The child might have had multiple toys back in his house. It's not the point. Why didn't the father buy it? Father was mature enough to understand it was not necessary. The mother tried to distract the attention of the child. She pointed out towards the mustard field and asked the child to go ahead and have a look at that. The child was a small child. Children are easily distracted. So he was easily distracted by the bees he saw in the mustard field, and it was yellow, entirely yellow, and there were black bees flying all around them. The child got distracted. He forgot the toy shop and he ran towards the mustard field and started. Although in the picture you see sunflower, but the picture has been put here to show the black bees that you understand. See, bees are of different kind. There are these honey bees. Generally, when we talk about bees, our mind goes to honey bees. Honey bees are small in size and they collect nectar from the flowers. But black bees are bigger. They also collect nectar and they don't make hives. They are and they don't sting. They don't stay away from people, unlike honeybees who sting people. So the child was distracted by them. Then what followed? Child followed a line of insects. Then he ran towards a grove and he noticed the doves that were sitting over there. And he gradually kept losing concentration. Finally, when they reached the fair, the first thing the child noticed was the sweetmeat shop. Sweetmeats were being sold. There were jalebi, there was rasgullas, gulab jamuns, and so on and so forth. But the child's heart was stuck with barfi. He wanted to buy a barfi. He wanted to ask his father to buy a barfi, but the father, he knew what would father would say, that he was greedy, he shouldn't be eating that. So he moved on. And the next thing he saw was a garland shop. The garland was being sold. He wanted to buy a garland. Mala ki dukan. Garland means mala. A string of flowers. A rope made with flowers. that's what we call it. So he went to the garland shop. He wanted to buy a garland, but again he knew his father would refuse. So he moved ahead. Then he reached, on the way in the fair, he saw a balloon shop. There were a rainbow colored assorted sort of balloons over there. He wanted to buy that. But what happened? Did he ask his father for that? No, he knew his father would refuse again. Now the point is, why did the child know the father would refuse? Because father was ready to provide what was necessary. If you remember the story of Abdul Kalam, you see, Abdul Kalam's father provided everything that was necessary, but anything that was luxury, he never provided. He was austere kind of a person. Likewise, the child's father was same. Now the child listened to a snake charmer playing his flute. You have already read about a snake charmer's flute or a pungi in the chapter The Sound of Music, how a pungi was modified into a shanai. You have already done that. This is the point of division. All the chapters are correlated and you figure out how. If you study one chapter, you are reminded of another chapter. But the child refrained from listening to the sound of the pungi because his father had told him not to listen to coarse music, harsh music. And finally, he reached a roundabout. And this was the thing he thought he wanted the most in his life. He could take on his father for a ride over there. But when he turned around to seek the permission, he found out that his parents were not there. He found out that he was lost in that fair. What a shocking thing for a little child. I'm talking about a child who is less than 10 years old, figuring out that he is lost in the fair without his parents. He went crazy. He started running in random directions. He had no idea how to figure out his parents. So he started running in random directions. What happened after that? He couldn't find that. Then finally he noticed a shrine, a temple, where people had lined up. And they were huge, muscular fellows. And the child thought that his parents might be there because so many people have gathered there. That's the child psychology. That's the way they think. So many people have gathered there, my parents must be there. So he ran towards the direction of the shrine. And he started making way under the legs of the big people that were queued up to visit the shrine. And he almost fell down and got crushed by the feet of the people. Because people were moving ahead, they were not noticing what's lying underneath or whether there is a child. They were not expecting that. And the child got almost crushed. And what happened was, there was a man who bent down and picked him up and saved his life. By this time, the child's turban had come off and his clothes were dirty. He was crying, eyes were full of tears. He was in a bad position. But this man saved him. Now, since the man saved him, it was the duty of the man to comfort the child. So what did he do? He tried all the things that the child wanted, one by one, in the reverse order. He offered him to listen to the offered him a ride on the roundabout. He offered him to listen to the music of the snake charmer. He offered him to buy balloons. He offered him to buy garlands. He offered him even to buy sweets. But the child wanted none of them. Now why? Why do you think the child wanted none of them? Because now, although the child was young, even at that young age, he had realized the most valuable things that we possess in our life is our parents. We can replace everything, but we can't replace our parents. So that was the message. Hopefully, all the children must have understood it. You see the pictures? They are coming one by one in the reverse order. Snake charmer, then the balloon, and the other things. But the message is, the most valuable things that cannot be replaced. We can replace everything. The balloon can be replaced. The snake charmer can be replaced. Everything can be replaced, but parents can't be. So value your parents. Love them. As long as they are with you. Okay. I'll take a leave today, students. Hopefully it was nice learning. Goodbye.